really excited about my new book. Bear with me, as this is my first educational book, Understanding the Global Climate Crisis for Students and Humanity Alike. This book is about a step-by-step, academically structured, basic foundation of understanding for those seeking to develop a broader understanding of global warming and climate change, as well as human-induced global warming and climate change, as well as a support structure for students connecting historical research to said topic. The first portion of this book is geared towards students, whereas the second half is geared towards a larger audience, such as the general public. Feel free to pick up a paperback version to take advantage of the journal at the end of the book, as I highly recommend the paperback version. You can pledge your climate change initiative and jot down your thoughts and start making a positive impact on your environment. You know, these last couple of years, I've been traveling all around the country, and I've developed a fondness for nature, and I love my planet very much. Portion of every sale will be donated to various disaster relief foundations globally. So don't be too critical, don't be too judgmental, because this is actually my first self-published book, not through a publishing company. This I published myself, okay? Entirely. And I put my heart and soul into this. A lot of research, a lot of man hours. And I think you guys and gals might really dig it. Go give it a read if you would like. Enjoy. And like I said, I highly recommend the paperback. Eventually, we will get a hardcover. And I'm working on getting into all the big box stores. Currently, I'm in review for Books a Million. We already got into Barnes and Noble, so good things are happening. I just wanted to plug that for a moment. Pretty cool stuff. You know, like I mentioned, on all my road trips, I have these opportunities to spend quality time in nature. And during those quiet moments in nature, I was reflecting on my environmental impact, and I realized that I was doing a lot of things that I felt guilty about. And I've always lived a very specific kind of life where I don't like feeling guilty about anything. I like to do the right thing as often as I can, integrity. And writing this book is my way of giving back to humanity and the planet ultimately. But a portion of every sale will be donated to disaster relief organizations globally. So your support truly goes a long way.
When the phone booth turns white, that's when I'll come home. I'm going up to see what I can show.
Cool, beautiful Pacific Northwest day, meandering a bit in nature, in the woods, looking for a pine, gathering pine for my pine tea. Check this out. Just found some red huckleberries. Got some English holly growing. I absolutely love this forest. It's very peaceful, very quiet. Lots of birds, lots of wildlife. So it's a fantastic place to just unwind, breathe, get back down to earth and take it easy. Today, I'm going to show you the difference between two specific pines. Western hemlock, toxic, and western red spruce, the good stuff. So let's go find some. So we have here western red spruce, and you can always tell by the bark. Now, western red spruce, in my opinion, is one of the tastiest pines, spruce, that you can harvest. It has one of the best aromas. Oh, it smells fantastic. It smells like Christmas. And believe it or not, Native Americans primarily utilize the wood for medicinal purposes. And this wood is currently utilized in culture for many different utilizations. You hear that bird? My man is going buck wild over there. Western red spruce. This is what we will be making our tea out of, and is completely safe for consumption. The next thing I'll be showing you is something that's not safe for consumption. It's actually entirely toxic, the western hemlock. Rather than explaining all the scientific details, all you have to do is utilize your eyes and your nose to determine which is toxic and which is safe. So right next to these red huckleberries, we have western hemlock. Entirely toxic, so this is not safe for consumption. So we have both the western red spruce, safe, and the western hemlock, toxic. Now as you look closely, you can see the distinct differences. Another way that the Native Americans interpreted whether a plant was edible or toxic was by utilizing their nose. One of our most primal instincts, believe it or not, is our nose. So trust your nose. You can smell whether it's toxic or edible. Now, for example, the western red spruce has a very rich, nutty aroma, very sweet, and the moment you harvest it, it smells edible. The Native Americans would actually chew the tips while burying bodies as it prevented them from getting nausea, which is wild and has been utilized
as chewing gum. This western red cedar specifically grows in the Pacific Northwest because it thrives in lush, wet, foggy conditions. Pull them right off. Almost as if it was intended to be pulled right off. Very easy. See that? In Lake Quinault, Washington, is the home of the largest western red cedar in the world, with a height of 174 feet, I believe, and around 19 feet in diameter, which is colossal. There are numerous medicinal utilizations of the leaves of the western red cedar, including chewing on the leaves to ease tooth pain, or even making a concoction that can treat your lungs. So the list goes on. It's crazy how many medicinal utilizations this amazing tree has to offer. Nature heals all. So get out there, forage some high quality red cedar off the beaten path deep in the woods. The bigger the tree, the better, the richer. So over here we have some rose campion growing. Red elderberries. Now these bad boys, believe it or not, are edible if cooked properly. Now the seeds inside can be toxic if you eat them raw, but if you cook them efficiently, they're fantastic.
I'm not afraid.
highly recommend performing a few of these movements that require you to harness your balance, because in doing so, your form will become more explosive. Your kicks will be accentuated by that balance. Everything gets better. Always remember how important balance is in life. So always try to find new creative ways to train your balance, because the more balanced you are, the easier life is. throughout the last decade, experimenting with many different forms of martial arts, many different disciplines around the world, I've come to the conclusion that every style is obviously effective in its own way, but one of the most critical things you must do in order to not only set yourself apart from everyone else, but make it a lot harder for other people to predict what you're going to do, is to ultimately recreate the martial art of which you plan to master.
Bittersweet moment, our last experience in Washington State. Epic road trip planned. Virginia bound first for business purposes, and then New York bound, Virginia bound again to pick Daniel up. New York bound again to spend time with family. Finally in August, Florida bound. So, I'll be filming all summer and exploring as much as possible, like always, loving life, living life, enjoying life, because that's what it's all about. I've said it before and I'll say it again. You gotta get out and indulge.
Definitely, I love nature. This is the best place to be.
Tomorrow, exploring Mount Hood, but this will be our last experience in Washington State. So, who knows? Maybe in a couple of years we'll come back, buy a cabin or something, because I do love the nature here. It's extraordinary. But life is all about the journey, the experiences, and the people that evolve the most are the ones that adapt to new experiences and new places. So, and that's the phase of life now. Just trying to explore. Enjoy and broaden our horizons ultimately. So, as always, join us on this journey. Let's have some fun. Quick pump out here in nature. Whatever it takes to maintain the gains.
You look adorable.
Not too bad, eh?
It looks really cute.
With the glasses and without.
I like it with.
Mm-hmm. And I know what you're thinking. Pete, man, you are red.
Yeah, that's why I made him get a hat.
We got mean burn at Mount St. Helens today. We got other things. Check this out. So, this is my hat. Now, Danielle also got a hat. She also got some new sneakers.
They're Peter approved.
Peter approved Cynthia Rally New York style for life. To match
really
the dress I purchased for her. Yeah, they look good.
They were like plain but nice.
And we basically just got a bunch of treats. Oh, show them my Nautica shorts.
Yeah, look at these puppies. Now it's looking.
Ooh.
These bad boys satisfy my sweet tooth without all the sugar. A little protein, good to go. Just some Hurley flip-flops.
They actually fit you?
Yeah, no, I tried them on.
16. These are 12.
I mean, this is the biggest I got, alright?
They fit you?
Your boy's a big boy. They're small, but it gets the job done. But these bad boys are really comfortable. I like them. That's all, haul. And thanks for tuning in. Later.
Later.
I'm calling as soon as I start.
It's probably Big J.
I don't know who it is, but I'm not
answering. What's going on, gang? Taking it easy here in Oregon City. Mediterranean veggie. Breakfast sandwich right here with cheesy bread. Impossible breakfast sandwich from Starbucks. We got my venti iced coffee, Daniel's with honeycomb macchiato. Soaking up the sun, taking it easy. Ready to explore around Mount Hood. Trying to walk over these trucks, sorry. Just living life to the fullest, right? Somewhere around Mount Hood, and it's cold, but it feels so invigorating, bringing me to life. Gosh, nothing is better than cold water for the muscles. Starbucks coffee, we got Panera coffee, check out the breakfast sandwich.
This looks so good.
Double scrambled egg,
this is
double cheese,
big sandwich,
Asiago bagel, check this out. Come get some.
How do you like it? On a scale 1 to 10, rate it.
20 million.
Ooh, I can't wait to dig in.
We out. Are you ready? Later. Cruising through Wyoming, we got Danielle in the house throwing down a veggie bowl from Chipotle.
This is really good.
Yeah, buddy. I'm also throwing down a veggie bowl, and I got double of everything.
Look at that.
Because he's a twerp.
I like being a twerp. I don't want to be a big girl.
Dollish. Take a bite. How is it? Away from society and civilization. As for me personally, it's the only way as I get older to get back down to earth. Aside from working out, but I find that escaping civilization and getting into nature is far more effective for bringing myself back down to earth and ultimately feeling alive, clearing my mind. Not only necessary, but integral and critical. I require this. It's usually these quiet moments when I'm all alone in nature, without anyone around, just me and my thoughts, breathing and relaxing, that are my favorite moments. So get out there and find those moments. Find that peace, find that solitude. spotted about 6 marmots, and Daniel actually walked up to one and managed to pet it as it was lounging. I couldn't believe it. Fortunately, I took my camera out a little too late, so I didn't get any footage, but we did get a few pictures. These breaks from life, work, business, training are so necessary and critical. And I always find that after these road trips, not only am I obviously invigorated from having time off, but I feel more mentally stimulated and motivated. I find myself more creative. So it's crucial to go on vacation, take breaks. If you're thinking about taking the road trip, or you're thinking about going on vacation, don't think, just go. You can't go wrong. You truly can't go wrong with a little time off. Treat yourself. Treat yourself, because you deserve it. You know me. I love my alone time. Especially in the elevation. And cardio in the elevation is incredible. That lethargic feeling, your heart pounding. It's so good. Daniel's the marmot whisperer. Over 10,000, heart is pounding, having such a good time. You feel that elevation? Man, he's performing cardio in high elevation. Nothing is better. In the summertime, it gets really hot, really dry, so you gotta rock a super cool hat, sunscreen, SPF. You dig, right?
Yeah.
You gotta keep your skin healthy. I'll be honest, guilty as charged. I tend to forget to wear sunscreen. So when I got Danielle with me, she typically lathers me up because, I'll be honest, I just don't do it. And I really need to get into the habit of doing that. So, do as I say, not as I do. Put on sunscreen. Maintain your usefulness. You dig? Really close to the parking lot. You don't have to wander too far. Yeah, this is a great place to just wander around and just take a break from the hustle and bustle of life, cities, and the hectic national parks. Like, Rocky Mountain was pretty chaotic yesterday.
It was.
That's what I tend to do. I find places where no one else goes, and I look for those spectacular views that you have to really earn in order to see. And usually, the further you go, the less people you see. Yeah. Careful on that edge right there. Come around. Yeah, buddy. That is a massive creature. We got this buffalo here, scratching his stomach, his post, for the last 15 minutes. Good scratch, he's on his way. Bagel World, New York style, big dog, flexing, yeah, see those double buys, baby, bam, what'd you bench today, motherfucker?
315.
315, hanging tough, just another day, right?
Yep.
Just another day, just another dollar. What are you throwing down over there, big dog? What are you eating, huh? What is this?
Messy ass egg sandwich.
Triple egg, triple cheese, New York style. Bagel world for life. Hell yeah.
Good stuff.
We got a little bit of everything here. We got a tomato pesto from Dunkin', some iced coffee. This is a muffin, right? We got the corn muffin. Yeah, just the New York breakfast. Virginia bound. And then back to New York at the end of July. Trying to convince this heathen to come to Virginia and hang out with me.
I'll get there, man. It's not that far.
Yeah, 7 hour drive. Not too bad.
You can do that.
Hit some good, bro. Looking damn good. There she is. And we're just hanging tough, loving life. So we made our way across country, settled down in New York for a little bit, and from New York I traveled to Virginia to meet up with Danielle, and we've been staying at this beautiful suite on a Marine Corps training base, correct?
It's like a Navy, Air Force, Coast Guard, and Marine base.
Regardless, beautiful suite. Been taking it easy, relaxing, settling down for a little bit, and preparing for our trip back up north to New York, and then the big road trip to Florida.
Hello! You're so cute.
We made it to this beautiful park in Chesapeake, Virginia. And you gotta see this. They have all these outdoor workout machines that cover every body part. So me and Danielle plan on banging out two sets of every single machine after breakfast. And over here, we got Danielle prepping Waffle House. Yeah, buddy. The good stuff, baby. Waffles from Waffle House and an impossible breakfast sandwich from Starbucks. Usually we don't eat dirty like this, but we've both been losing a lot of weight because we've been very proactive, training sometimes 2-3 times a day. And I've been losing a lot of weight, so I'm just trying to bulk up. Look at that waffle. The good stuff. Have you ever had Waffle House?
I've never had Waffle House. I'm super excited.
Oh man, what an experience.
It's fun.
You're in for a treat. The best waffles ever. Trust.
This is the perfect place to burn off.
Hell yeah.
Thank you.
over here. We got Danielle hanging tough, getting ready to throw down a feast. Another day, another waffle. Yeah, buddy. We got some scrambled eggs, sunny side up, Dunkin' Donuts, caramelized latte. You know how we do, and of course, a couple of cornbread donuts. Now, we don't usually eat like this. When we go on vacation, we splurge. We like to enjoy and get it out of our systems, right?
Definitely.
Today is one of those days, as you can see. So we about to get at it. Why don't you put a donut in my mouth? Cornbread time. Check this out. God dang.
Oh, so good. Man.
Danielle needs a new bikini.
Who's gonna help me pick it out?
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
Here in Norfolk, Virginia, at the super cool and super smooth Botanical Gardens, check it with Danielle. The best part of filming is I can re-watch it later and experience everything all over again. That's one of the main reasons why I love filming. So we are here in beautiful Norfolk, Virginia at the Botanical Gardens, and I gotta say, this place is amazing. It's so peaceful, it's so quiet, there's lots of room to wander, butterflies all over the place, happy people, beautiful flowers. Can't beat this. Nice. Nice. Really good. One more. Thank you.
So we made it to Hudson Valley, New York, back home, back in town, back in business. And today, we're hanging tough. Wandering around Annie Reed State Park, having a good time, drinking some coffee, strutting, killing it. That's about all there is to it. Alright, well, I'll see you on the flip side. Old historic Hudson Valley. Check out these beautiful ruins. Look at this stonework. You gotta love charming, historic Hudson Valley. Check it. Finally made it to the notorious Letchworth Village, renowned for its paranormal activity. And today we'll be investigating the entire area. Be careful in there, Danielle. This is the first building we will be investigating. Wow. And we already said our prayers. That no spirits follow us home. I can understand why people assume this is haunted, because when you get inside of these buildings, it's kind of crazy, but you can't hear anything. You can't hear any traffic outside. You can't hear any bugs. We definitely have to be careful in here, because as you can see, a lot of these buildings are deteriorating and falling apart. It is of the utmost importance to watch your step and take care, correct? Now Danielle's gonna grab the flashlight out of my bag, because it is time for some serious investigating. Oh yeah. Sorry about that, guys. That was not a ghost. That was my ankle. Also highly recommend anyone thinking about coming here to investigate bring masks. Could potentially be breathing in asbestos. You can still see their clothes hangers and
Oh my
everything.
God.
You come in peace. anyone here? There's an elevator that goes down. It's flooded. That's all water. That's flooded. The question is, where is the staircase?
I think this is it. Yeah.
What is that smell?
I don't know.
It's really bad up here. Exploring Letchworth Hospital, and I've noticed that the most activity, the weirdest vibes, for me personally, have come from downstairs. And in fact, my camera battery almost died downstairs, and then when I went upstairs, the battery was full again. So we have here what looks to be the remnants of something of a fountain in this beautiful nature preserve here at John Burroughs Nature Preserve. And I think at one point this was something of a garden and fountain. Historic New York. Gotta love it. And I thought this was really cool because it looks like this stone structure was hand-carved. Oh yeah. Lovely. And as you can see, all these stone walls were made by hand. Ultimate knowledge. If I were to name the three most precious resources of life, I should say books, friends, and nature. And the greatest of these, at least the most constant and always at hand, is nature. The good stuff. That, right there, is powerful knowledge. The good stuff. And over here, we have this beautiful, handmade cabin in the woods, made on the very same land that it was created with. Same wood, same rocks. Beautiful. It's just perfectly constructed. And I thought this was really cool. If you look over yonder, over here, you can see where John Burroughs was chipping away at the cliff and gathering stone to create the base of his cabin. And those stones were placed precisely. Look at that. Amazing. And then if you look through the windows, it might be hard for you guys and gals to see, but you can see all of his old possessions and books, stuff like that. Let's see if you can see inside. It's really hard, but if you look really hard, you can see a lot of his possessions within. So peaceful here. I feel incredibly positive just relaxing at this cabin. I can almost feel how he felt relaxing in nature, taking it all in every day, enjoying peace and solitude. And as I always say, that is what I enjoy the most in life, getting away from society and culture and just getting back into nature and truly relaxing. It just fills me with hope and energy, and I'm ready to take on anything.
They all look so hungry.
Mm-hmm.
The same one with the ear.
Some females. Try to men will use cologne. These guys then fight each other for females, and the winners get to breed with them, and the losers do not. And then we'll draw up antlers in the months of February and March. Guys aren't familiar with how antlers work. Antlers grow through a stage called velvet. And the velvet contains the blood vessels and veins that allow the antlers to grow up to an inch and a half a day. Once the antlers are done growing, the deer then scratch off that velvet and turn into something called calcified bone.
Oh. They're really friendly.
Hmm.
Now I'm gonna have to give
a lungy piece in half.
I gave you one. Tucker, is this Tucker? Listen, hey, is this Tucker?
He's like, but I'm here.
Yeah, he's there. There we go. Here we go, Tucker. He's like, I'm mad at you when I turn around.
You are Tucker.
Is this about as big as they get? Or they usually get any bigger than
that? Oh, they grow until roughly the age of 7.
Okay.
They're both males, and they can grow roughly 17 to 19 feet tall.
So we're here in beautiful North Carolina, hanging tough. They got Danielle over yonder, sipping on her Panera. How's that iced coffee treating you?
It's pretty good.
Take a sip. Super cool.
Gotta have your iced coffee in the morning.
Yeah. You got a breakfast sandwich, double scrambled egg, double cheese, Mediterranean veggie. No better way to start that day than a little fresh mozzarella, onion, tomato, lettuce, pickle. The good stuff. Veggies, you dig? Look at that. God's eye.
Elbows up.
Now it's walking.
Feels so good. Oh wow. Love them.
Finally exploring Blue Ridge Mountains, and we made it to the Green Knob Watchtower. Unfortunately, as you can see, they locked it up, so we can't actually go into the watchtower. But if I really wanted to, I could climb up the side. But I think I'm gonna follow the rules on this occasion.
You never follow the rules on any occasion.
Thank you.
a little bit. I'm not sure how long. We may end up back on the West Coast. We may not. Right now, I'm just kind of living and learning, experiencing, and seeing what I like. And that's what life's all about. Living, learning, experiencing, and finding those places that bring you to life and make you happy. A little hot coffee, a little green tea, iced coffee, a breakfast sandwich, a little scrambled egg, everything bagel, cherry vanilla bagel, pumpkin scone, impossible breakfast. God damn. Feasting. Because all we do is train, right? So we can just eat, eat, and eat. Thank you.
Perfection. It's never enough, man. You work as hard as you possibly can and perfect every fucking thing like a madman. That's the only way to get better and better and better. Understand? That's it. So now-
Thank you. Yeah. Oh,